Waking up in a dream, sleepwalking on another big stage. You never heard peace till you hear people scream your name and you're the son. I'm so far away from the place I used to be.
In one of the latest of a series of embarrassing events, the Lakers lost by a franchise worst 48 points to the Jazz a couple nights ago. So suffice it to say, the Lakers have had a god-awful season. So awful, in fact, it's a franchise worst season. They currently stand at the bottom of the Western Conference rankings with a 16-59 record. But no matter what Byron Scott says, this god-awful losing season was planned.
Why is it important for you guys not to use the dreaded word tank, but to play hard the rest of these games?
Well, I think it shows what you're all about as an organization. You know, we're not trying to tank games. That's absurd.
The tank master Byron Scott has struck again with what I believe is his best stealth tank job yet. Allow me to lay down the facts as to why Byron Scott is the greatest tanker of all time, and this video might also explain to you why Byron Scott does such asinine things all the time. It's not because he's stupid, it's because he's a master tanker. Or he's just fucking stupid. I mean, after all, he does say shit like this all the time that makes absolutely no sense.
Kobe came out and took a lot of shots really early last night, talking about wanting to shoot you guys off to a good start. Does that kind of set the tone for other guys going ISO and the ball sticking?
It could, you know, so, you know, he has that privilege, basically. You know, from a coaching standpoint, I want Kobe to be Kobe. Other guys haven't earned that right yet.
To tell you why Byron Scott is the master tanker, I have to take you back to a time long past, a much simpler time. A time when Shaq was the shit and Kwame Brown was shit. 2001. 2001 sees our stealth tank master take his first head coaching job, the New Jersey Nets. While his Nets roster was not deep, they had a legitimate superstar in Stephen Marbury, number one pick of the 2000 NBA draft Kenyon Martin, and Keith Van Horn, who by the way was a season removed from averaging 21 points per game. Our boy Byron led them to a pretty bad record of 26-56, and landed them the 7th pick in the upcoming draft, which, although irrelevant, they later traded for Richard Jefferson, Jason Collins, and Brandon Armstrong, all solid pieces. But see, here's where it gets interesting. After such an abysmal season, like I said, 26-56, ya boy Byron goes for back-to-back finals appearances with his New Jersey Nets for the next two seasons. You may say this was because they upgraded the roster by trading Stephen Marbury for Jason Kidd. Well, Jason Kidd is a very good point guard, but on the other hand, so is Stephen Marbury, at least at the time he was. For perspective, Marbury was averaging 23 points per game and 7 assists, while Kidd was averaging 14 points per game and 10 assists. Whilst Kidd was an awesome passing point guard, it's not like they didn't have an all-star point guard before Kidd arrived. And as for the rest of the roster, well, they were pretty much the same as the last year, and remained mediocre at best. So what happened to make Scott's Nets go from 26-56 to two straight finals appearances? Well, my theory is Byron was tanking at the request of management to get their pick, and once they got that pick, Byron had his team exit tank mode. So, as we can tell, it's not like Byron is incapable of coaching a good team, much less a finals-worthy team. Matter of fact, he did it twice. Let's fast forward to when Byron became the post-LeBron coach in the wake of LeBron leaving Cleveland. While it certainly wasn't hard necessarily to tank in Cleveland for the first couple of years, but let me just say, Byron accrued some absolutely atrocious records for 4 straight years, and you know what those atrocious records turned into? 3 number 1 draft picks and 1 number 4 draft pick. Well played, Byron, well played. I mean, granted, those rosters weren't exactly good, but goddamn, how do you play so bad to get the number 1 pick 3 times in the span of 4 years? Especially when you have one of the best point guards in the league in Kyrie Irving for the last half of that. Easy. You be the tank master, Byron Scott. So if we look at the past 5 years of Byron Scott's draft position, you will see that his teams have had the first pick with the Cavs in 2011, the 4th pick in the 2012 draft with the Cavs, the first pick in the 2013 and 2014 with the Cavs again, and the second pick in the 2015 draft with the Lakers. That gives ya boy Byron a top 5 pick in every draft in the last 5 years, and an average draft position of 1.8. 1.8! This guy has been doing a masterful job. I mean, I don't know how any coach has had so much fortune in the lottery, except it wasn't necessarily fortune that helped Byron. It was his masterful adeptness in the art of the tank. Fast forward to today, to the current atrocious season of the Lakers, masterfully engineered by your boy Byron Scott. Are you starting to see a pattern here? The Lakers pick is top 3 protected, meaning if it falls out of the top 3 in the draft, they lose it to the Sixers. So Byron Scott has to do what he does best to make sure that the Lakers keep that pick. The best part about it is that Kobe's whole going away tour is the perfect cover to give an aging horrid Kobe, no offense Mamba, way too many minutes, which we all know is hurting the team's winning chances. Other super sneaky moves to make sure his team becomes one of the worst teams in the NBA to keep his pick includes when randomly Byron Scott will play Grandpa World Peace for 30 minutes for no apparent reason, like on the night of the 48-point loss to the Jazz. Or like when he refuses to play the few up-and-coming young guys, Julius Randle and D'Angelo Russell, in favor of Swaggy P. It's little sneaky things like that that make you wonder whether Scott is doing this on purpose, or he's just a horrible coach. And I'll give you my answer right now. Byron Scott is doing this 100% on purpose. As we've seen, Scott is capable of being a good coach, dare I say. Take for instance the back-to-back finals appearances with the Nets, and when he won Coach of the Year and multiple playoff years with the Hornets. But like I've been saying this whole time, your boy Byron is a tank guy.
I'm beginning to feel like a
tank guy, tank guy.
All my people from the front to the back, not back, not.
And what we are witnessing this year on the Lakers is the best stealth tank job possibly ever. So no, Byron Scott is not a terrible coach, he's just a really good tanker. Anyways, it's Rain Sanity, and I will see you next time.
A fool if I take it all for granted, a smart man if I keep my feet planted to the earth, cause the people that hurt can understand it. You speaking outlandish, I'ma show you how to make it all work. Another planet is a short term goal for me, a record soul for me, it's just more of me in your ear. For you to hear Kendrick persevere, defenses I fear, relentless ambition with a clear vision. Taking off, I ain't taking off these pistons, I'm taking off on the enemy, your distance came across.